The list is a sequence container like a vector, but optimized for rapid insert and delete operations. Lists do not support random access. You'll notice we have the template function for printing a list and our message functions. Again, these are just for convenience and to keep the code in main free of the clutter of these repeating patterns. Here we initialize a list using the template syntax. So this is a list of integers, and it's initialized with the initializer list, which is available beginning in C++ 11 and is a very convenient way to initialize these containers. We print the value of it, and then we print messages for size, front, and back. When I build and run, you'll see these here. There we print the list and size 10, front 1, back 10. This should all be familiar from the vector. We can use pushback to put an element on the back. And here we have the 47 on the back of the list. And in order to insert and erase elements, you need to use iterators. And so here we declare an iterator. I'm using the full syntax here. We'll use auto later. Auto works just as well here. But this is the full syntax. You have list, you have the template type, and you have two colons and the iterator. And that'll get you the iterator type. Our first iterator is iterator 1, and we're initializing it to the value of the begin function. And so we want to insert the value 112 before the element with a value of 5. And so we use the iterator to look through the list until we find the value 5. And assuming our iterator is not at the end, we insert 112 before the value 5. And that's right here. You use the iterator as the first argument to insert and the value you want to insert as the second argument. And you'll notice here we have insert 112 before 5, and there's our 112 before the element with the value of 5. If we want to erase the element with the value of 7, we can do the same thing. We can search through the list with our iterator for the value 7, and then we use the iterator here in erase. Erase the element pointed at by that iterator, and here you have the value 7 is now gone. There is a convenience function called remove that will do this for you. You simply call remove with the value that you're looking for, and it will remove actually all the elements with that value. So in this case, it's removed the element with the value 8. If we had more than one, it would have removed all of them. Or again, using iterators, if we wanted to erase everything between the value 112 and the value 9, we can set up our second iterator using auto and initialize both iterator 1 and iterator 2 to be begin. And we search for 112, and you notice there's nothing in the body of that while, so it's just setting the iterator. And the same looking for the value 9. And assuming neither of these iterators are at the end, we can erase a range beginning with iterator 1 and ending with iterator 2. Now, this is a non-inclusive range, so it starts with the value at the first iterator, but it ends just before the value at the second iterator. And so you notice we're iterating 112 to 9. It gets rid of 112, 5, and 6, but not the 9. So we still have 9, 10, and 47. STL lists are an excellent choice for situations where you don't need random access and you'll be inserting and removing a lot of elements. They're fast and lean, but at the expense of some functionality.